because they don't have any ways to deal.
Also
Spock, he can
pick.
dodge. Bro,
almost full legless.
So that's we expect that to be a Zai puck.
Could be, yeah.
Okay. This again, you go back a little bit, but we have seen four position puck.
It's Bane IO. It's an off lane, but they could swap things around and the
okay. DP.
Right, I love
course,
DP. I love DP.
Yeah, I think that's a great hero pick there. I think we're gonna see game five.
Yeah, I'm loving this draft from Virtus Pro, and not a big fan of IO and the Bane combination. I think they lack control with these two.
We talk about the Death Prophet, EG. Used it quite a bit. Why are we starting to see all of a sudden in our final day? I think we saw EG use it yesterday as well. Why are we starting to see this in the later portions of the tournament, Nahas?
Well, I think the silence is just so good against a lot of these spellcasting heroes. She is a hero. Again, you have to play around that exorcism cooldown. We're going to have a hero with her like a Jug or a Terrorblade that can offer sustained tower damage. And use the exorcism for the fight, they'll take objectives afterward.
All right, well, VP, they started to get their momentum back. Now they have a fantastic draft. Is it going to be enough to take this all the way to a game five?
Game five would be beautiful. Please allow us to have game five. More great Dota, more great drafting. This one feels nice and close. The panel's bouncing around. How do you think, Kyle? You're looking at your five picks and you're like, what's really good here? And a puck pickup from Team Secret.
I love the puck because really no offlaners left. None of these tanky strength heroes do a damn thing to a Jug in the laning phase.
Yeah.
Puck also gives you some form of control against the BKB's Virtus Pro pickup if you get an axe. But still, like this looks like an outdraft for VP. Mm-hmm. Like that DP rests the entire lineup of Secret.
It almost feel like this is the first time that Team Secret don't have that big pushing lineup at the very beginning. It's a PA as Nodi is dragging it back. Puck, of course, he is a great split pusher. Yep. He can just go onto those side lanes, and he's been really popular in doing that. You give your team fight, but you just can delay the game up. But with Virtus Pro's lineup, they got such great synergy between the Grimstroke, we can't even talk about like Soulbind, potentially double Dooms, double Storm Bolts. Like, this in itself, if they can get that off in a team fight, it's great. But we were also debating it during the draft. How do you get such a combination off against Team Secret, who have been so good with their positioning?
Yeah, it's just this is the first time Secret are the ones on the back foot. They don't have that mid-game skirmish power that they've had in the previous three games.
Is this also the way the draft was done? Like, VP changed the beat up. It's like, well, we could react to the IO first pickup. Like, we could pick Disruptor. We can get the Grimstroke now. It's like, no, we're going to go Jug. We're going to go Sven. We're going to be the ones in control of this draft and not allow Puppy just to walk all over us like game two.
Yep. I like that they gave away the Wisp, too. It demonstrates confidence. You win the game, hard fought. You're going into the next round, and you can pretty accurately predict what Secret's gonna do, and they were prepared with their response. They took time to select each hero, but they didn't use anything but reserves, or none of their reserve.
Yeah.
So, I like the Jug Sven.
Just out of curiosity, do you still get the 15 on Ire? Is this your free Aghanim Scepter for the puck? Even though that's a very difficult target to say connected to when he's going for the Dream Coil.
Yeah.
Like, there's nothing for a PA. OD, you kind of don't want to give that one, right? It's...
I think you're fine going this is one of the rare games I think you might actually go the Spirit's hero damage on the Wisp at level 15.
Yeah, it's like nothing you want to sync with.
Although Puck Ags is sick in this game. It's another scenario, Virtus Pro.
But when he blinks in, like, Puck's gonna have to walk forward to Dream Coil.
Yeah.
That's the downside I was worried about.
Yeah. VP, they love this triple BKB core lineup. Obviously, Jug might not be buying one, but he's got the spin, and you need some form of control. This is where the Bane pick a puppy comes in. It's traditionally a dual laner in the mid lane, and it gives the OD a big edge, which he really didn't have in the previous game.
Dual mid. This is a fun meta. You know what? I'm actually kind of sad that this meta gets to end. This meta has been one of the most entertaining metas we've had from game to game. Yes, we've had OP heroes, but the OP heroes change, like, from game to game, from tournament to tournament. It's just been so dynamic in the way it gets played.
Yeah, we're comparing it to TI4, but let's be real, that entire tournament was death ball. This is the first time we've really seen this kind of pressure.
Yeah, I don't want to compare it to TI4. TI4, I almost fell asleep in the grand finals, and I was casting it. Mid lane rotation's coming over from Grimstroke, but he's walking underneath two Observer Wards. So the OD's already done his banishment, and maybe that's why Death Prophet thinks he can actually start the fight, but it's support on either side of the river. It's not what either team are really looking for.
I like the Pucks pick once again, though, because Zai is just not really able to be pressured. Yeah, you can zone him a bit as the solo Sven, but he's never... The thing that threatens offlaners when you're Jug is if you can just solo kill them or keep them out of lane, because they're melee heroes. Puck, you just always sit here,
Nightmare.
You never die.
They're going again. It's a level 1 imprisonment. The damage just through Nightmare may be enough. Death Prophet has the banishment, and she'll die. This is first blood in mid lane, while on bottom lane, they almost won the race with this bit of Ramzes chasing the Puck under the town, but first blood does go the way of Team Secret.
That's unfortunate from Zai. He had to use the Q to juke the stun and ends up getting killed because of it.
And Grimstroke's being a real pain in the butt. Here they go again in mid lane. A Nightmare. It's a level 2 imprisonment. Grimstroke's got his own stun, and they just banish him. Say goodbye to the stun. It doesn't exist when you're in the Netherworld. And that's Roger. Gonna go down as well. Maybe with a Fairy Fire he can survive. No, one more attack from Puppy will do the work. So difficult to win the support versus support matchup when you're up against a Bane. Solo should know this better than almost anybody else and tell it to the rest of his team.
And even though he died, Zai's still doing significantly better in the bottom lane than his counterpart in the Doom. And not just in his own CS, but the way he's forcing Ramzes to miss a few under his own tower and as he's chasing Zai. Up top, Pasha's being zoned out pretty effectively by Nisha and Yapzor. They're laning very well up here.
Look at the change of targets. You send Grimstroke up towards the top. Puppy instantly moves to the bottom lane to try and make sure that Ramzes doesn't get a good game. Double CS is for 3 of the heroes so far. You know Ramzes wants to go for the dive, but Stormbolt and Ramzes starts his spin. There's no way to stop him when he gets the body block off, allowing Sven to have more stun time. Okay, maybe that's one way to do it. Nightmare as well as the one hit. Oh, Juggernaut so low, taking so much damage from the tower. The orb, he jumps over the rift damage. It's going to be enough to get the counter kill. So Zai's having a good lane. You give him a kill and Ramzes, he's having a great lane.
This is great for Secret. You need your Puck to have a good start. This is the hero that'll really be able to make plays. Puck or OD, PA, they need so much time to come online. They don't really want to be involved. Zai will create the chaos, and then perhaps they'll add in. Maybe they'll keep farming, who knows?
Pasha? He hung around a little longer than was the Inkswell available from Roger, but that'll only be something to dissuade them.
He has 6 stick. He's fine. He's got so much health regen on the Doom as is.
I think Bane's going to find another kill. He just picked up a double damage rune. Any target he goes for the Nightmare, but up on top Nisha. There's your easy jump away. Ire, as well as PA. Max range on the tether, stays it up. Now over towards Bane. We'll see how this Nightmare and double damage rune serves Puppy when the spin comes out. He can try it again. Nightmare is available, trying to counter it out. They wait a little bit of time. They can't attack because Zai, he's waiting it out. The spin, Puppy waited until the end of the spin, but then Stormbolt over on 2. Ramzes can go to work. Silence is there, but Zai will still take a big chunk of damage from just the swings of Ramzes. And up on top, Inkswell, nice jump from Nisha. Dodges it at the last moment.
Really back and forth laning phase, as expected.
Exactly what you wanted to see. 8 seconds before the rune spawn up, and these teams, they're going...
Well,
just
Virtus
great
Pros
plays against each other.
Yeah, VP is actually going to be able to control all 4, it looks like. That's Nisha, Tom. Nope, he won't be able to even contest that.
Downside about PA, can only jump to something.
Indeed.
Not like a Queen of Pain.
Like that if you're Virtus Pro. Your only real struggle is this mid lane, mid 1, already up to 14 denies, and Death Prophet, it's similar to heroes like Viper and Razor, where you need to be ahead in the lane if you really want to contest. When you're behind, you can't utilize your drains as effectively because the enemy hero is going to just out-trade you, and you end up losing, you know, it's like a 30-70 now in what is usually a closer to 50-50 matchup.
But are you still okay with this? Like, okay, it's 3-3 on the board. Doom, we've seen his recovery, so even though he's 13-1 and not having as great a game as Zai, Pasha's still going to recover.
Yep.
And Ramzes has been having a terrible time on bottom. As this game drags out, who do you even feel confident with?
Well, the concern for Secret's lineup, if you look at it, is incredibly low damage and low team fight. If OD gets doomed and PA, you know, and it's not 30-40 minutes into the game, Secret really don't have any AoE. You can coil them, you know, Zai can use a round of spells, but Virtus Pro, they have so much sustain, the healing ward, the heals from DP, the Doom Devour, the Sven shield. I fear for the lineup of Secret if they aren't able to abuse their map mobility and the relocate.
Invis room for the Sven. He didn't actually see Zank fast enough. The Observe Ward was looking for it. Nice D Ward from Puppy getting rid of that high ground vision. that was available to the Death Prophet. So Puck has finished up her shrine. And Ben's waiting to see when someone's going to come back into the lane, because at the moment, Juggernaut's having the freest time in the world. While Puppy wants to go on Death Prophet. Not level 6, only 3-1 charges available. And they're going to go. Silence on bottom lane. Zai still waiting for that Stormbolt. Solo was silenced up. That's the reason why it hasn't happened yet. Maybe worry about the phase shift, but there's the Stormbolt. Got in nice and close, so there was no way to just phase shift out the attack. Still will orb away, but he burnt Shrine so we could stand in the lane. Now that doesn't happen, but up on top lane, he'll find, even though the PH was full. Grimstroke help. They move in with Ink before. They won't try to find this, the PH, but underneath the tier 1 tower, not that will fight.
Hey, it looks like the equalized. It's actually, for just a moment there, Nisha and Ramsey's exactly 50 denied between them. I'll change up now.
And there goes myself as well. I'm kind of feeling this game is going to be going since the rest of the series. I'm ready to go into the team fights. Let's just chill out.
The Doom just not going off Nisha time. And even though he was out of guest for a bit, this is the nature of the Doom here, especially when Roger shows up to help him. He's suddenly level 6. This top dual lane is still just level 4. And VP with a big level advantage in the side lanes. Yeah, you're behind middle, but that's important.
Great information getting produced by Soul. Ward up on the high ground near the top rune, but he just planted a fresh one from the tree line. So Team Secret will probably not be aware of this. It's just out of range of the detection mid lane. So instead, they observe with their points in silence. But Nisha has nothing else to jump. The Spirit Siphon should be damaged, but they're battling underneath. Shrine supports rotating in the form of D. At the same time, PA just want Anthony to wait. Well, Ramsey's, that's not what we want to have happen. The bottom lane. And Nisha just goes to farm up in his own jungle onto the south. TP to Ryan.
I like this choice. Can't be top anymore. You just way too susceptible. He has ultimate cooldown. There's nothing you can do. Pop a camp real quick and then go look to top lane from Zai.
And they're going again. Solo is waiting. He knows the puppy wants to go for something. But the storm ball, Death Prophet. He moves back. Spirits giving a little bit of extra life. They need to slow people down, but these pulls from Yapsaw makes it difficult to close the distance. There's your slow coming in from the Stroke of Fate, but he's up the hill and away, so Sven, they couldn't get the Chain Stun from the Inkswell as well as the Stormhammer.
Surprise mid one, looks like he might just be going for another Midas build.
They want to keep going. The Dire Observer Ward just sees Puck. Now he does have Dream Coil, but Doom has Doom.
And max silence as well on Zai.
Oh, Stormbolt. Puppy trying to dodge it. As quick as he could with the Nightmare, he'll Nightmare over on Doom, they'll free him out. Yamsaw's nearby, tethering over, doesn't have a lot of regeneration provide, but it's just a slow on Doom, and then the Dream Call over on 3, and the Hammer! Mid 1, he hits like an absolute, well, Anvil. Two heroes go his way, Doom, but this a little bit too heavily forced.
A little bit, Toby. They want to use the Doom, you want to ensure you get these ultimates off, but...
Juggernaut's looking for a solo kill, but he doesn't have Omni Slash available. He's going to lose all 4 bounty runes. Maybe no bottom lane. Sven will be able to grab that. Yeah, but Nisha takes the top 2.
The key hero to watch for Secret is going to continue to be Zai. This is the guy that's got to be able. He makes the turnarounds happen. Without the coil, without the silence, you can't stop Pasha from getting his spells off. And Nisha still needs some time to come online, although he's really considerably farmed. Since he had to leave the lane at level 4, and he still found a way to maintain his acceleration, looks like he'll be going for the Battle Fury Rush as well.
A late game Nisha PA to carry the game. Wow, I think I've seen this before somewhere, Kyle. Is this a rerun?
I mean, Ramsey's on the jug as well. Like these, both of these players are on signature heroes, not just for themselves, but in the meta too. Now, I'm just happy because this means this game will be going late. You've got a Midas picked up on mid one, and the more time we get to watch these two teams play Dota against each other, the happier I am.
Those two kills really just sent him over to the edge for it. Yeah, he got like 350 gold for it, but it's what allowed him to afford it by the 10-minute mark.
I want to see him look to itemize a bit differently. I'm not a huge fan of that Hex Rush he was going for in both of those first two, the two games he played OD already.
Puppy gonna tank another gank. They kind of want to kill off the Puck. They're even faking out the Doom on bottom. Here's your Silence over on Bane. Can't Nightmare when that's on him, but he gets rid of it. Stormbolt flies forward, gets a double stun. Puck, he's protected by the Invis Rune. Now he comes back out of it, trying to help out Puppy. There's no TP support coming in, so this Dream Call will be massively ineffective. And they try and get a trade-off. Mid one's pushing the mid tower, but there's no D pushing a tower. Well, VP have four heroes forcing the lane. Grimstroke, he'll TP to the mid and just stop that secret push.
They still have the DP ultimate ready as well, so they get the tier 1, they could potentially threaten tier 2, but I feel like Zai is going to just spam out this wave and ensure that's not possible.
Yeah.
And if you look at what mid one's queued up, he does look to be rushing that Scythe of Ice again. I'm not sure how much I like it. They already have such single target DPS and lockdown.
Unless they can just ensure that Doom can't get the Doom off. Like
exactly.
That's, like, okay, Doom's walking at me. He's going for the Vlad's build, so it'll be a while before the Blink Dagger will arrive. But then this is a bringer. He hasn't maxed out Devour just yet, but eventually it will come. And they look for another target. Smoked up. They'll see Puppy. We are walking around during daytime for the 2.5 minutes. So they leave an Observe Ward behind. Imprisonment used on mid. Puppy's moving over. He's got the Nightmare and the Fiend's Grip used on Grimstroke. But they all got Soulbind together in the double Doom and the double Stormbolt. That's the combination that VP's been itching for. And the Omnitouch, I'm trying to relocate him out. It won't work. They take three heroes. Virtus Pro. You feel like maybe they're the ones being initiated on, but you feel disturbance. That is not right.
But they fear nothing, Toby. These heroes are so strong. Look at the health pool. Every single hero of VP, exception of Solo with 987, is above 1,000 health in this mid lane. And Secret, you're still so swifty. You have a Midas, a nakedness on your OD. And Bane.
It's all about dodge, right? It's having the Nightmare, it's having Imprisonment, it's having Phase Shift, yep. It's having the IO sustain or the relocate back out. But when BP initiate and they get a double Doom, it disables so many of these abilities.
Yep. I mean, that's just the dream, right? You just blow your ultimates. They were waiting for this opportunity for some time. 7-7, game still equalized, but VP's lineup will thrive the longer this game goes.
It's like Pasha just walks, like, we talk about, like, how do you get this combination off against Team Secret when Pasha just walks in the fight? But phase boots and the fact that Secret were initiating on a different target, he stood still because he was trying to Fiend's Grip and kill off the Grimstroke, and they got him at least. Yep. Grimstroke died, but they lost so much.
And it's some of this tale of the tournament thus far. You got one team, Secret, they're looking to find an initial kill on someone 100-0 before they can get a single spell off. Virtus, you have so much sustain, so much staying power in engagements that you're confident as long as you survive that initial burst, you will win these fights just because of how powerful your heroes are as the team fight continues and continues on. Like, you have DP all churning, you get the Doom off, and you have so much more reach as well. Like, you're just going to charge after people with that maxed out war cry of the solo Sven.
Yep.
Like, they're so fast.
God, it really is crazy. No one with the defensive fuel scepter. He can even be aggressive with that if he wants. And he's going to build into the hood. Ensure that magical pop damage of Team Secret just doesn't explode the Death Prophet. Max duration on Exorcism. Push down buildings if they want to. Even their Observer Ward placing on bottom lane. Ensure that their farm areas are secure, but it all lets them have an early detection warning if Team Secret want to try and push down the tower. And surprisingly enough, they're coming down. They're not in range of the ward. In fact, Doombringer is nearby. And now they're going to see him. It's the 15-minute runes. Puck, he'll jump forward. He'll bottle that one up. Dream fall out, Pasha. He'll try and survive through this. He'll not get the score strength off, but it won't matter anyway. Can't walk away from the Dream Coil. So Doom will die, and this is Secret's turn to get a lot of bounties.
I love it. I mean, both teams, the best teams in the world, of course. I keep saying it. 15 minutes, they're already ready. They're prepared for an engagement on the rune. These bounties are objectives.
I think you can say the best teams in the world. They have been in the winner's bracket final and the grand final of two consecutive majors. The only two in this DPC season so far, and of course they're the only two teams that have qualified for TI so far. Both rightly so, but VP and Secret, like, they dominated the last DPC season too. I think Secret qualified like 4 or 5 months into the last DPC season.
Yeah. And you have a blink on Zai. We saw it not really used there as the Doom was just standing on the rune, but that's the player to watch. In addition, this OD versus Doom relationship. Will OD be a hero in these? Whoa, what?
What?
He died of the ancient stack. Oh my god. I have not. Wow.
I don't know if we can go back in a replay and just watch that in slow motion. If Production has that available, but if you do, I would like to see that. And yeah, you're right. Yapzor, they jump over, they realize they screwed up on the Ancients, and Yapzor with a relocate. They'll find what they're looking for. In fact, they may find more. Puck's ready to go. It's a double silence and dream call, and they drop the ultimate. Virtus Pro, what just happened here?
Holy sh... That's the first real individual.
Solo is too much damage. The AWP flies forward. Solo must run to the left and heal Dainese. It's a double kill. This is crumbling right now.
This is what makes teams good. It's not about even how many mistakes they don't make. It's how do they respond when the enemy team makes a step. Ramzes dies to Ancients. They're relocating there to steal them within 5 seconds and then immediately turning around under their own ward on tier one tower. Mm-hmm. 4 kills.
It was the Observer Ward as well that was at the room that saw the fact that he died there. That's how the information, it wasn't even just a straight up read. They had the vision of Ramzes dying in front of them.
That's the first time I've seen Ramzes make a move like that. Guys played near perfect this entire tournament, shit, this entire season. And VP go on to lose this game, you gotta point to this moment as the reason why. However, big spells of Secret are on cooldown. No relocate, no Bane Drip, no hammer.
In they go.
You said it.
Roshan crumps down. No one has already burned the Exism, and he's not inside the pit. He's letting the Exism do the work from the north side. So the Juggernaut's the only one risking himself. Io has the spirits in close. Here comes your AWP forward. Initiating onto the DP. It's really difficult. The Storm Bolt sent over towards Bane, so they've lost the double stun ability. But wait for the Soul Bind. He's looking for a target, even a double damage rune. Juggernaut, maybe it's worth coming out of the pit for this. They get the Aegis Immortal, and then they D into Ramzes. They want to fight. They're looking for anything. They trigger anything they've got. It's the war cry to get forward. Virtus Pro, they want to go forward so fast.
And you can see Doom is running at 5.11 move speed when War Cry, Scorched Earth, and Phase Boots are active.
They're backing up. Virtus Pro, even with a double damage rune on the Juggernaut, they don't want to force the issue into Team Secret just yet. Even though Tanny's Eclipse is down for the moment.
A bit less action-packed than the previous three games, but you can still feel the tension. Both of these teams have such a great read on the flow of the fights. Who's more powerful in what position? You can tell that they know exactly when they should or should not be engaging.
Yep.
And I think Secret make a wise decision there. They pressure, saying, you know, VP, do you really want to force this? Because they can't fight, but maybe VP make a mistake, they leave the pit. But both teams make the right decision.
I thought Nisha was like on the opposite side of that, trying to farm up Juggernaut's areas.
Yep. While Ramzes is farming his own.
Mm-hmm.
And the blink on Pasha is going to be big. I like his decision to go for the War Stomp build here. He wants to be more, he's an initiator. If you look at the lineup, VP, they just need to get on top of Secret. If you can get a disable or fast kill on the Bane, the Puck, or just the Doom on the OD, Secret no longer have the ability to teamfight. They need that initiator's advantage, and they have to get a pickoff on someone. If that doesn't happen, you're going to get wrecked in these engagements.
It still feels pretty funky for mid one. Like, he's got BKB, but it still feels problematic against the Doombringer. And Doombringer, they're trying to give Pasha the space on bottom lane to afford up his Blink Dagger, because VP need this. Don't rely on Soul Bind, just rely on deleting the OD or potentially the Puck. Either will do.
20 minutes, they're smoked right on top of the room. This time it's VP who lay in wait, setting the trap. Secret wisely will not fall into it, and Pasha will collect the bottom bounty. So three runes going the way of VP. Secret still with a net worth advantage, but a lot of that is this OD Midas.
These are the runes VP wants. As we said, Doombringer's trying to afford his Blink Dagger. He's now up to 1900 gold. Not far off. Ramzes attacks the top town. This forces the fortification. There's no creep wave with him anymore. And he'll turn around. Warcry, a little bit out of range there, Solo, but it won't matter. And Ramzes spins, ensures that he's got Aegis Immortals at all the confidence for Ramzes.
We saw this in previous games where teams game plan for Wisp. The way to beat it is to remove Relocate as a way for Secret to play. Stick is 5. If you want to fight us, if you want to find kills, you're going to need to take us on toe-to-toe. And you just can't do that if you're Secret. The teamfight disadvantage is too high. And you have a pipe on this no one Death Prophet. You could consider going tier 3 here just because, again, you're so strong. Even with a net worth disadvantage, you got to feel confident to just keep pressuring.
Yep. But do they go off Virtus Pro? Tier 2 town is being pressured in mid. PA is pressuring the bottom tier 1 tower. Yep, they're gonna come up. Ramzes enters the base. They've still got Stemptor Swamp inside the Doombringer, waiting for his own initiation. Another early spin from Juggernaut, beating into the tier 3 tower, being the frontliner. And there's your Doom! He got it on the OD! Stormbolt out as well. They'll take the tier 3 tower. Remember though, they're here for more. Base has to break free of the Fiend's Grip, but this just opens up Burnus Pro to keep the pressure going. It's a great silence, but still, the damage. All they're gonna do is just stay there, but without the Kree Wave, they do not want to stick around. A blink forward from Phantom Assassin, also not where she wants to be. Remember, Juggernaut has Omnislash. They get the stun. They were just baiting him. It looked like Crocodile Tears. It's a huge armor, but the Omnislash is even better. So much damage. They haven't found a kill. They haven't found any of them. The Silence of Dream Call won't do his work. OD Orb will. 24 intel stolen. He's starting to hit hard, but Doomringer back to fight. Blink and Hoofstomp off cooldown right now. And he gets two. They need to kill the IO. Spin forward from Ramzes. He wants to stay on the front lines. A Silence on the Bane. Nightmare's coming off cooldown. They want to punish. Burnus Pro maybe in a little bit too deep. Doombringer sacrificing himself. He'll stay around to try and get the, well, just to soak up some of the stuff. But your scepter, it goes on the Death Prophet. They're looking for Sven. Stormbolt, spaceship to dodge it by Zai. He'll get one, they'll get two, and Virtus Pro, too deep, too deep, too deep.
Man, what, that was all Zai, all Zai. Multiple three or four man orb silences. That initial engagement, he killed the healing ward that was just placed by Ramzes. That's why VP chooses to turn and run out of the base. And, you know, they turn on Puppy, but he effectively traded his life away, as we've seen Solo do so many times. He doesn't care. Immediately he's going to buy back. And that means his team now has time to turn around and continue this engagement.
And look where they go. Man. They understand that Ramzes wants to get back into farming, into recovery mode. They smoke up. Yep. They move over. You don't have a blink, but you've got a scythe. That'll do the work. Look at Ramzes. He feels it. They're showing in mid with the puck. Spin back up. Grimstroke barely survived thanks to his Glimmer Cape. And they're healing warding him up. They want to try and fight, but without Exorcism, without Death Prophet being fully up, they don't do it.
There were big silences from no one in that fight too, but they invested a lot into that push. No one bought a pipe. This is not an item you want to ever be purchasing on a Death Prophet in a game that could continue to extend for maybe 20, 30 more minutes. Like, he will get outscaled now. And how many times have we seen PA, especially Nisha PA, carry games once you get up to that level 20, level 25 talent?
A lot. Pushing in with the triple stifling daggers. He's at level 16 right now. Didn't go for the cleave, went for the armor corruption, and then even going to amplify the fact with Desolator.
And you have so many methods of removing Omnislash. You can Astral. You have now a defensive Yules that could be utilized by Zai. Also, he's the one that interrupted that no one TP to find that bonus exit kill.
Yep.
Just really on point this series.
It's the Zai show. In the same kind of way that you saw Crit Carry EG, Zai stepping up to the mark. Dire Observer Wards are here. Solo stays on the high ground. Look down. Arcane Rune reveals everyone's gonna kill him. Roadchuck, walk away. Or maybe not. Sven, he'll get the war cry off. This is just Puck. Puck just jumps in really deep. He'll end up getting the kill over on Solo. And Nisha, to the protection of his BKB, jumping into the back lines. Kill off Grimstroke as well. They're going for more. Actually, it's gonna be Puppy in mid lane, sent up in towards the air. The Doom is on the OD. He's just waiting out fight. So Pain will die. The Silence is out. Nisha, smash. Yeah,
nice. Relocate!
Combined with the Omnislash Pro, relocate! Really?
Wow, Yapzor pre-casted that. He knew Nisha was in trouble the moment he got slept. If he held it for another half a second, I feel like someone's gonna be able to interrupt that.
He's coming back. They're looking for the kill, but the Hex on Grimstroke. They have the damage to kill off Io, and under the Exorcism, maybe they got the DPS, but Puck back in again on the fight. They're taking so much damage thanks to the Rift as well as the follow-up. Death Prophet, she needs a little bit more space. Running away, but that crit from Nisha is coming into play. Doombringer's on the run with almost no armor, but it's up towards the top. That's where mid one finds a double kill. Virtus Pro, is this happening again?
White.
The whole team is dead, and Team Secret, they take a huge engagement. Another big plays. Support's doing the work, but my god.
And four bounty runes are going to go their way as well. All of a sudden, a full team wipe, a 10,000 gold lead, and, you know,
it's
we're
money.
Talking about late, like, Secret, they have ODPA, a level 20 PA at that. Desolator on the way.
Same with the BKB for the RD.
That might be it, Toby. That is
good.
A lot. And you can see the Omnislash, if they don't, they didn't kill PA. And that's Secret. If you can get through the Doom, if you can live through the Omnislash, the VP damage disappears. And perhaps now you're the ones that thrive in the longer engagements.
I cannot believe how much experience Tunisha got. Like, yes, he said, like, level 20. He's already looking and saying, okay, Satanic time.
Oh,
he's already going to get the Morbid Mask.
It's 14K all of a sudden.
Yep.
Zai's going to have an Ags and 1,500 gold.
Dude,
and
the bigger graph is the experience. That's about 18,000. Need advantages, just keep racking up.
That's the power of Puppy. Like, he distracted the Doom and the Death Prophet with alt active. Sure, you killed him, but he dragged them 15 for 15 seconds. They're just chasing him towards the mid lane. And Ramsey's like, hey guys, can we kill this PA? He just slept himself.
He actually got the Aghanim's upgrade. Still wants to claim it. For the IO, that is.
You can do cool stuff with it. OD Ags is pretty interesting.
Yeah. I suppose, like, when you're ahead, it's good. Like, when you're behind and you're imprisoned, everyone's like, we're gonna wait before we can attack. That's where the downside of imprisonment comes. But in towards the mid, Death Prophet shows itself in the side. They put down the Observer Wards. There's a lot of support behind him. OD walks forward. Careful of this. They already put the Sentry Ward down. Limit Cape and Fiend's Grip. But look, instantly Zai. He's always looking for more. He's looking for the Major Dream Call. Able to claim it with Death Prophet. Burning Exorcism. Now Team Secret can just back up. They do not have to fight. And it's a huge ability to go down. But then, no! He wants to go in! Roger just gets evaporated by Nisha. And the Hex, the follow-up, another Rift, another Silence. Maybe there's some damage to be done, but Doombringer. Seven towards the air by the Yulzhen, but Omnitouch is being thrown up by Puppy. And finds the kill. Io, well, they can live through this one. Maybe not so much. Doombringer, we can't close the distance. Yapzor's got the speed. He doesn't have any heroes to help him out. Three heroes down for Virtus Pro. And Nisha will come high ground. This time, I think the Rax will die.
Got a blink on Ramsey's. God, having struggles to find.
He didn't even use Sandy's Eclipse. He just got the plus two multiplier as well. Put the Null Talisman back in your inventory. Actually, he's waiting for the Kaya to come on the courier. Mid Rax is gone. Virtus Pro are on the ropes.
Got vision everywhere as well, Toby. Roshan is up. They could choose to go grab it whenever they'd like. 18,000 gold lead. And Nisha. They just do too much damage.
Notice Nisha has changed his item build. No longer going. Actually, I think he's still going to go for Satanic Ramses. He needs to get out of range of the Dream Call on the back of the spin. Has TP available. Will blink into the tree line so they cannot find him. This is delaying any kind of aggression that Team Secret could use. But that's all.
You need a miracle at this point.
I'm sorry. He's not here.
Exactly. And Pasha, he's finding decent initiations, but the damage output is suffering. You have Omni Slash that it's finding kills on Puppy reliably, but that's about it. And look at no one's items. Like, he hasn't accelerated, he hasn't scaled. He's now so far behind even Zai. And it all comes down to that top engagement. You know, you didn't get enough.
You don't have Exorcism. You probably don't have the damage output you're looking for.
I think you have to try, though, Toby.
It's a hard ask. Juggernaut still doesn't have the damage. He went Manta Battle Fury until that Butterfly is up. He's not really that intimidating, and Team Secret are already moving quickly. Under the cover of a four-man smoke, or actually a three-man smoke and a blur. Radiant scan, no one's nearby. They are at Roshan. Maybe VP are looking for the counter-initiation when Secret go in, but a full Satanic is now completed on the PA. She's unstoppable and looking for a Nullifier next. Puck reveals on bottom. Everyone from VP need to TP back, or they take Roshan now. Do you lose the second lane of Rax in order to claim Roshan? Exorcism is up. They can TP to the shrine, potentially. That was left up, but nope. Everyone TP inside the base. Tier 3 tower's being taken. And they're happy for these to be the front lines.
Gotta say Tanic.
Yep. And Satanic on the triple stifling daggers, it does proc the lifesteal.
And the issue you're running into now is Virtus Pro. Sure, you can continue to delete the OD of mid one, but he's got the survivability thanks to his wisp, thanks to the peel of the puck to continue surviving. And Nisha's a problem now. Mm. He's the highest net worth. He's got so much farm that the moment the Doom goes out, he fears absolutely nothing. And the moment he identifies a Virtus Pro support, he's jumping on top of them and killing them.
There's a double damage rune in the top river. Actually, it's going to be picked up by Puck. I thought if you give that to the PA, Roshan doesn't stand a chance. But here comes VP once more. They'll grab the 30-minute bounty rune from the top. But Team Secret already took the lion's share of the 30-minute money. Pushing the advantage now to 22,000. Almost 30,000 on the experience. It looks unlosable for Team Secret, but they're up against Virtus Pro. Anything is possible. This is Dota.
Yep, they're doing a great job, though. They know the only way they can lose this game is if they allow VP some sort of breathing room due to their own mistakes.
Oh,
just
can't
survive.
Distance and speed. They've already got the Hex over on Grimstroke. Fiend's Grip so quickly. Not to mention the Dream Call. Oh, that's Alpha! Mid one! He just wrecks face.
Blaze, the Omnitype is kicking out, but he doesn't even get a kill from it. Nightmare from Bane, Pumpy survives! The Doom goes on PA, but who gives a crap? They can't live. Death Prophet will come back up again with a couple of Spirit Cyphers, but they just waited it out, and now Death Prophet will die as well, and GG, well played! Team Secret will be the major winners over Virtus Pro, 3-1. They achieved what they were unable to do in the last major in KL. They have taken out Virtus Pro, and they do it with one game to spare. What a great run.
Incredible fortitude as well. Like a tough game three. You've got to feel like they made mistakes, yet they pull it together.